Let's pretend that we're going to Hawaii for Christmas with some friends, and we want to impress them with what we know about the sky. We first want to change our location to Hawaii. Honolulu, to be more exact. And we want to change our time to Christmas at 9 p.m. So 9 plus 12 is 21. And it's still light out because we're 9 p.m. December 25th Eastern Standard Time. And there's a 6-hour difference between Eastern Standard Time and Hawaiian time. When it's 6 p.m. in the Eastern Standard Time zone, it's only 12 noon in Hawaii, so we need to add 6 more hours. Now we see that it's actually 12:26 at 3 a.m. to be 9 p.m. Hawaiian time. Let's take another look at our horizontal menu bar. I'm going to click this little triangle, turn it into a box, to have it remain viewable. Now let's take a look at this equatorial grid. When I turn that on, the lines look more curved. If I turn on the azimuth grid, the lines look more straight up and down. I'm going to turn off the equatorial grid for the moment. If we look at these stars, especially the ones close to the lines, it looks like they're moving. And that's because they are. The screen's being updated at 15 frames per second at the moment, and actually adjusting those stars just a little bit as the time passes. If you can't tell these stars are moving or don't have the patience, we can speed things up by clicking this little fast forward button. When I click that, notice the seconds are going a lot faster. If I click it a second time, the minutes move like seconds, and we can actually see the stars moving through the grid. So what we have here is little play button. The play button sets the time back to the normal rate of time, and our fast forward can make things go faster. And we also have a fast reverse, which of course makes time go backwards. We can also pause time. And if we pause time, we can have the stars remain exactly where they are right now for as long as we want. If we really want to get crazy though, we can make this time go really fast and make days go by in seconds. If we turn on the equatorial grid and speed up time, we'll notice that the grid moves with the stars. This last button here resets the clock to the current date and time. So right now we're at 12:25 at 9 p.m. Hawaiian time, or 3:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. When I click this button, it takes us back to what time it is right now in our Eastern Standard Time zone, which is 7:09 at 7:16 p.m. These next three buttons, we've got the ground, cardinal points, and atmosphere. The cardinal points are just the north, south, east, and west symbols. The ground, we can turn the ground off. And here we don't see any stars because of the atmosphere still on. If we turn off the atmosphere, we can see the stars a little better. If we go back to our current date and time, it's the daylight. But if we turn off the atmosphere, we can see the stars. So we can follow the stars through the day as well as the night if we turn off the atmosphere, because the stars are still there. They're just hidden by the atmosphere. This next button turns on the nebulas. And nebulas are distant galaxies or any bright area or clouds of gas in outer space. Let's click on one. Now if we hit this center button, the same thing as we did with the space bar earlier, it brings the object we clicked on to the center of the screen. Let's zoom in a little bit. And here we can see what a nebula looks like a little closer I'm going to hit the backslash to take us back. I'm going to right-click to turn off the nebula information and turn off the nebulas. Now the next one we look at, planet names. Here we can see the moon and Jupiter. If we turn off the planet names, the labels go away. We would have to know what these are to know that that's the moon and that is Jupiter. This next button, switch between equatorial and azimuth mount. If I turn it on and turn it off, we don't see any difference. Let's turn on our equatorial grid, the blue one, and our azimuth grid, the orange one. Now if I speed up time a little bit, we see that the equatorial grid stands still and the azimuth grid moves, as well as the Earth. This next button, night mode, that's if you're out in the backyard with your laptop and the whites are too bright. It dims the screen a little bit. And our ocular view, if I click it, it tells me I must select something first. So I will select a star, click it, and we'll see that it gives me like a telescope view, allowing me to focus in on a single object.